What's up guys, it's Chase from Chase's Workshop, and in this video I'm going to show you how I built my CNC controller for under $120. This is the actual board right here. We're going to go through all the parts, where to get them, how much they are. They're all going to be linked in the description too, where you can go down and click on them and go buy one if you want to. If this helps you out, please give me a like. If you like it, please subscribe. Thanks for watching guys. Alright guys, so real quick I'm just going to go over all the parts and then we're going to zoom in and go over them individually. So all we have here, it's not a lot, but it looks like a lot, I know. We've got the four driver boards. These two are both from my Y-axis. I've got a Y1 and a Y2, so I have two motors from my Y-axis. And then I have an X-axis and a Z-axis. These boards right here are SMAKN, I think that's how you say it, SMAKN. Like I said, they're linked in the description. These are actually $14.90 now. When I bought them, they were right at $16, $17. So like I said, they're cheap. They have a revised version of these, but the revised versions don't have as good reviews as these, I guess because they're newer and they haven't got all the kinks worked out in them. These are actually rated from 9 volts to 42 volts. So if you get a 48-volt power supply, make sure you adjust them to work under their specs. The next thing I want to go over right quick is just this breakout board. I got this from CNC4PC.com. They also actually sell these on Amazon now, so I'll link that in the description too. The same company does, and they have a lot of good stuff too there if you haven't been there and seen what they've got. CNC4PC.com. And they have all kinds of different things. I'll link them in the description too. They have a lot of good stuff. This right now is $23 on Amazon. And the board that I'm going to link in it looks a lot different than this board. A lot of these components and stuff are surface mounted underneath now. And so this top just looks bare. When I first saw it, I was like, that's not the same board. But according to them, it's the exact same board, just smaller components and stuff for it. And like I said, $23 on Amazon. So $14.90 for each of these and $23 for this board here. The power supply is a 24-volt, 15-amp power supply. I bought this one on Amazon, too, and it was linked in the description. It's $23, or $21, $21 right now. So, like I said a while ago, if you're wanting to use the 48 volts, make sure if you're going to use these drivers to adjust this little potentiometer here down to where you're only giving out less than 42 volts so you don't fry your driver boards. This right here is just an old computer supply that I had lying around. Technically you don't need this. You could just buy a little 5-volt power supply or something, but I was thinking in the future I'd like to have maybe an Arduino board in here, something that I can run different things with. And so I put this in here. All it's doing is it's sending 5 volts to my breakout board, and it's sending power to a fan, which I have disconnected right now because this stays open now and I hadn't put a top on it yet. But anyways, now we're just going to go, I'm going to zoom in and go through all the different parts and how to hook them up and stuff like that. So stick around. Okay guys, so here's our driver, one of our driver boards that we're using. And like I said, you can see down here where it shows you your voltage rating, 9 volts to 42 volts DC. These are just receiving power right here. The whatever your power supply is feeding to this voltage CC plus right here, and then you have a ground. So it's coming off of the power supply to here. We're going to go over how the breakout board connects right quick. It just comes in with three pins actually. There on your breakout board, there would be a pin 2, then there would be a common between it, and then there would be a pin 3. I've got on this one, you can set up however you want to, but on this one I've got the pin 2 coming in and going to direction pulse right here, or the direction, I'm sorry, right here. So it's on the red, so it's going to this one here. Okay, on the common on the breakout board, we've set the breakout board to send common as 5 volts plus 5 volts, and I'll show you when we go over the board how to do that. But anyway, so that's this red wire coming in right here, and this is 5 volts coming in, and it's feeding right into the direction plus 5 right here that you can see, direction plus 5, and then there's a jumper right here that's circling around and coming to our pulse plus 5 volts. So that common that we're running from the breakout board is going to both of those, and then the number 3 pin that's on our breakout board over there is coming to here, and it's actually the pulse So we have a direction and a pulse coming from our breakout board, and we have a 5 volts coming. So direction, one pin, pulse, one pin, and then plus 5 volts is another pin over there. So each of these driver boards is getting three wires from our breakout board. And then this is where the motors hook up. And all these four wires right here, you have a B negative and a B plus and an A negative and an A plus. And those are pretty straightforward when hooking up your motors and stuff. You can figure that out. Once you get your motors, do a lot of research on them, and this is really simple. So like I was talking about a while ago, these dip switches, they're back here on this back side right here. You know, and there's six of them. So there's three right here, and this first block, I'm trying to move this out of the way where you can see it. This first block right here is the actual first three pins. The second block is the next three pins. And so you just go through there with what your specs are. Like I said, mine, I'm using, let's see here, micro steps. I'm using 8 micro steps. And that tells me I need an off, on, off for my first three. So the first one needs to be off, on the second one, off on the third one. And then, like I said, my motors are pulling about 2 amps, 2.2 peak, current's 2.2, somewhere around in there. Or 2.0 to 2.2, so my steps are on, off, off for the 4, 5, and 6 ones. Like I said, these are easy to figure out. I mean, you can look at them and figure out how to do it. So that's really all there is. And like I said, this board is $14.90 on Amazon. So like I said, it'll be in the description so you can get one just like it. Okay, and here's our power supply. And like I said, this is a 24-volt, 15-amp power supply. It actually has three different voltage pluses out. So we have voltage here, voltage 24 volts here, 24 volts here, 24 volts here. And we have three grounds. Ground here, ground here, ground, ground here. So for these first two drivers right here for my y-axis, I'm using one of these legs, 24-volt leg coming up here, and it's just going to here, voltage for a driver, and it's jumping to this side for voltage. So it's feeding both of these. And then I have a ground coming back to my first on my ground. And then this white one comes up here and goes to my other driver board over here. And the ground comes back to here. And then the black goes up here and goes to this driver board back over here. And comes back. So this is, wire these up is pretty simple. If you wanted a second board, you know, a second power supply, you could mount it next to it. And you would just, instead of using this red going to these two, you would put a red from this board over here to these two, and then a ground back to that board. So that's pretty simple, pretty self-explanatory. Like I was saying a while ago, there's a little dip switch right over here on the back side of this that you can adjust it up and down for, like, this is, if this was 48 volts and this board doesn't, the specs are for 42 volts, you can come over here and you can put your meter here and adjust that voltage down to where you're not putting 48 volts onto your 42 volt driver board. That's pretty much it on that. Okay, here is the breakout board. And like I was telling you a while ago, we had to set these commons. So you can see a common is between each of these. Like we have pin 2 and 3. There's a common right below that. We have 4 and 5 here. There's a common there. 6 and 7 common there, 7 and 8 common, 8 and 9 common. So we have a common between every one of these output pins. All right, now if you look at this pin right here, or this, I guess this would be pins. If you look right below it, it says 1 to 2 is a common equals ground. And then if you flip this to 2 and 3, 2 to 3 common equals 5 volts. So you want this to be on 5 volts to send 5 volts to each of our boards. And like I said a while ago, I've got 2 and 3 hooked up to one board with the common, or to one driver, 4 and 5 common to a driver, 6 and 7 and a common to a driver, and 8 and 9 and a common to a driver. So that's easy peasy hookup there. Of course, you have your parallel port that comes in right here from your computer, and you have this right here is actually I'm sending a voltage out and bringing it back on pin 15, and this is for my limits. I have limits on my machine to where if it hits a certain limit, it shuts the machine down. And then we have our ground and 5 volts coming in, and then I jumped this to I don't remember why I did this, but I know you need to make it work. Jump the 5 volts to EN here. This pin says EN on EN. And you have some more inputs here too, where you could do more if you wanted to. You could do more, send more limits out if you want a limit for each of these, or however you wanted to do it. And that's really it on the board. I will make sure, if you're going to get one of these boards, make sure you have a computer that has a parallel port. If you don't, they do have USBs to parallel, but I've never used it, so I don't know how all that works, if they work good or not, and if they do, or if you're going to do that, I would do a lot of research on it.
Well, all right, guys, that's it for this video. If you have any questions, comments, please leave them below. I'd love to help you out in getting your CNC machine up and running. If you need information on how to hook this thing up to Mach 3 or any other software, that your controller software, just search it on YouTube. There's a bunch of good videos on YouTube about Mach 3. I use Mach 3. You can figure out how to hook these pins, different pins up to the breakout board and stuff like that, and it's not hard at all. But if it is hard, let me know. I'll make a video on it. I don't care. I'm wanting ideas for videos, so if that's something you want me to do, just tell me, hey, Chase, make a video on it. Okay, I will. Also, Tim, I'm probably going to do maybe a series where I'm going through my workflow, and basically what a workflow is, if you know what a CNC, you know what that is. You've got a CAD program, a CAM program, a controller program, and then you know everything, how I get from there to a product, an idea in my head to a product in my hand. How do I do that? And I'm going to go through it. So if that interests you, please subscribe, and if you like the video, please give me a like. Thanks for watching, guys.